Hey there, Internet. I'm here to show you MSI's brand new update to its GS63 VR. If you remember, back in October of 2016, we reviewed the GS63 VR, the big deal, incredibly small laptop, full-on GTX 1060 performance. The new thing, though, is this. The update to the GS63 VR is now called the GS65 VR. It is, this is a prototype, so it's not quite perfect.
That's pretty.
Still aluminum shell. You'll notice MSI said, you know what? We're getting a lot of business people. They're telling their bosses they need more powerful graphics for Excel spreadsheets and probably playing PUBG. So they've really gone upscale with this, making a little more suit and tie. You get black and gold.
Even around the edge.
And there's not the standard red kind of emblazoned in your face, even down to the keys. Per key lighting they have had, but what they decided to do with these new keys is they went with skirts. So the previous ones, they were wide around the base to give out a little more light. These are actually sealed up to be a little more formal, a little more business. You don't want to think like, whoa, did I buy my employee a gaming laptop? Yes, they did. Probably this one. Big difference, obviously, if you know the GS63 VR, look at the bezel. This is a near bezel-less design.
That is nice.
Not totally bezel-less, and so it's a narrow. It's about an inch narrower than the GS63 VR, GS63, and big deal, no nostril cam. I stole that from you, Cliff. Yes, the camera is up on top. Look,
what?
We get the cameras and the mics on top.
How they fit that?
Which is actually very impressive.
I may actually
look at the video quality on that because it is nice to get the webcam on top. I don't know how many people are doing their webcam shows, but apparently they are. But a lot of these laptops, they're putting the cameras down low, looks up your nose.
No bueno.
No bueno, not good. Look at your hand or your nose. So they moved it on top. Pretty cool. Of course, big deal, inside Core i7 6-core chip. I know there's a Core i9. This is not going to fit a Core i9 in there because of the thermals, but still you're getting a 6-core Coffee Lake CPU and a laptop that, of course, is super thin.
Nice. What about the graphics card?
Graphics card in this particular one, you get two options right now. GTX 1060, GTX 1070. Yes, Max-Q. For some reason, nobody's marketing that way, but both those parts are Max-Q parts. As I understand it, they are pretty much full spec, and you're getting, you know, roughly my testing of Max-Q 1070, 1060 parts, maybe 10% off a full 1060, 1070 Max-Q part.
Nice.
Other changes, really big changes, especially for the GS63 VR. I love that laptop, but the battery life wasn't great. The reason, MSI put a pretty small battery in it to get all the cooling for all the hardware of that time. They put a 62 watt hour battery. That basically meant you're lucky to get 5 hours out of that. Not gaming, of course, just general use, 5 to 6 hours. This is an 82 watt hour battery, so they put a super large battery in it. They say 8 to 11 hours, basically all day use. And let's face it, you're not really working all day at work anyway.
Does it make it thicker? What's the difference?
It's actually a little lighter, interestingly. This is a 4.1 pound laptop. The previous GS63 VR, I keep calling it that, GS63, was 4.96. So definitely lighter. What else has changed?
What about the screen? Touch screen?
On the screen, so no 4K. Touch. Not 4K, but I want to touch it. The screen is 144 hertz.
Oh, nice.
All right, very nice. 1080p, 144 hertz with wide viewing angle. You know what that means? Non-IPS, NVA probably. So it looks pretty good. Matte finish. Other changes, big battery, improved cooling. And also, they said, hey, if you've ever tried to get inside a GS63 VR, it ain't fun. This one, they said, we've improved it. Yeah, it's not like a big Bertha laptop where you can just open up and add parts, but you can get inside this one. There are two M.2 slots, no hard drive slot. I'm okay with that. It's fine as long as you can have a little more storage using two M.2s. There are also DDR4 SODIMMs, probably a little hard to get to. I would probably not recommend that, but they do say that this is a lot more serviceable, a lot more easy to get inside than the previous GS63. And here's the other thing. 144 hertz NVA panel, G-Sync obviously, and this.
Oh, no way.
Yeah, wow. I mean, this is pretty rare to see a laptop, laptop, especially that has a full 180 screen. This is kind of like an old-fashioned ThinkPad in a way. I got to say, I like it. A lot of people are like, what do you need that for? But if you're standing over it on a bench, if it's low, you kind of want to low point the screen back. You know, a lot of laptops will go to about there, and that's it. And if you're standing high, you want a little more angle, you're going to go all the way here. This, again, is a prototype. I don't want to break it. But near bezel of the screen, top camera, no nostril cam, 6-core Core i7 CPU, 16 gigs, 256 gigs, Max Q, 1060, $1,799 if I've got this right, 16 gig, 256, Max Q, 1070, $1,999. So $1,800 for 1060, $2,000 for 1070. You know, it's going to seem pricey compared to like really big thick laptops, but when you get to sort of this form factor cramming all these components in here, it's not easy to make. There's a lot of stuff, a lot more detail you got to pay to it, so not bad. Oh, for ports, let's go over this. USB looks like I see a Thunderbolt port, so we get a USB Thunderbolt mini display port, full-size HDMI, proprietary charger, which I'm going to point out, check this out. Guess which power brick is more powerful. Yeah, it's a smaller one, right? You knew I was going to say. This previous power brick, I think, is 150. I'm not sure. I can look it up. But this new one is 180 watts, and it's actually smaller than the previous model that put out less power. So they've said, hey, we've heard you. You want smaller power bricks. So they paid Delta to make a smaller one. Let's look at the ports on the other side, and I think we're going to be done. Two USB Type-A's, USB probably 10 gig. A full-size Ethernet port, and actually MSI said they made it a point they wanted this thing to be a little bit thicker because they wanted to put a full-size gigabit Ethernet a port on there. They don't want to deal with dongles, none of that stuff. This is interesting. You still get your dual analog audio.
That's always nice.
Dyn audio, a new gamer mode, so it actually sets up and changes the key profile for when you're playing a game. If you fire PUBG, it actually lights up the keys the way it's supposed to be. They've in fact preset that up. Killer NIC 1550 AC 2x2 part. And what else? I think that's it. I gotta say, that's a big upgrade. Again, we're looking smaller, faster, not cheaper, but easier to service. Sequel and to the famous GS63. I love that laptop. It was really, at the time, a trend-setting laptop. This looks like a worthy successor.
And I like the design. It's nice. The gold.
Yeah, you get the gold.
Yeah,
this
fancy.
Is like you convince your boss.
Yeah, fancy.
Boss, I got to. There's GPU acceleration in Excel now. I got to do some WebGL. Oh, okay. Talk to purchasing. Oh, I need a Max Q. I've read about that. Okay, fine.
Nice.
Yes,
cool.
Yes, very
we'll,
nice.
We'll check back in when we get a chance to test it.
And we will get a review model. Come back to PCWorld.com to see the formal review. Let's see if it's all that.